Hello everyone. Can you all tell what comes into your mind as soon as you hear the word mathematics? Some of you might say numbers, some say addition, subtraction, the shapes like circles, triangle, etc. Yes, you all are right. But math is much more than this. Math is part of our everyday life. Just say for example, when we wake up in the morning, our first action is to look at our clock. Then, when we go for breakfast, ask for 2 slices of bread. We will again be using math if we dial numbers. We all love shopping, and here too, math plays an important role. Say, if there is a discount, then you can see how much it would be, if it was maybe 20% off or something. So like this, there are many incidents where math is used and hence is so important to learn and understand, as the word mathematics itself means the things that are learned. One of the very first thing that we learn in our childhood is numbers and its counting. We've also learned some basic operations that we apply on them, like addition of numbers, subtraction, multiplication and division. The answers that we get are called sum, difference, product and quotient. Now the area of mathematics where numbers are combined with some basic operations and their calculations forms a different branch in math called arithmetic. The operations are called arithmetic operations. So in this session we are going to learn one of the most important branches of math known as algebra. So what is algebra? Is it same as arithmetic? Let's understand it. We know that in arithmetic we can easily say 8 plus 2 is 10 and 7 minus 5 is 2. But suppose someone asks the same question in some other way. That is, how much amount do we add to it to get the total of 10? Or how much should we remove from 7 to get the balance of 2? Okay, so the answers for these blank places are 2 and 5. Here what we are actually doing? We are finding the value of the empty place, which we don't know yet. Hence, this empty place also called as unknown. But every time we cannot use the words like empty place or unknown. And hence, in algebra, we denote this unknown value, that is this empty place, by an alphabet. And it can be any letter, A, B, C or say X, Y, so on. So, instead of keeping it blank, we use an alphabet. And therefore, algebra simply means finding the value of unknown numbers. I'm sure you have now understood the difference between arithmetic and algebra. Let's take an example to learn few more things in it. Suppose you have a small stationery shop where you sell one pencil for 3 bucks. Customer 1 comes and asks for 5 pencils. Customer 2 asks for 7 pencils. Customer 3 directly gives you 12 bucks and asks to give as many pencils as you can for 12 bucks. Friends, your price for a pencil is a fixed amount, and what is unknown to us is either number of pencils or total amount for the same. Let us first find out the unknown values here. Now can you tell what should be the total amount for 5 pencils in case of customer 1? It is 3 into 5, that is 15, right? Similarly, for 7 pencils, the amount will be 21 bucks. So what did we do exactly here? We have multiplied price of a pencil with number of pencils sold to get the unknown total amount. But for third customer, in 12 bucks, what will be the number of pencil? How to find that? Well, all we have to do is divide the total amount 12 by price of a pencil, that is 3, and that will give us 4. Now please observe the table and understand that here cost of pencil is a constant value, while the number of pencils purchased by each customer varies, and as a result, their total amount is also different. So if we denote number of pencils by X and total amount as Y, in general we can write it as 3X equal to Y. Friends, 3X simply means that 3 multiplied by X, or sometimes 3 dot X. Dot also represents multiplication. Now note that here X and Y are unknowns whose value is not fixed and it's varying. Hence in algebra, unknown numbers are also known as variables. Now if we concentrate only on 3x, we can see that we have constant 3 and the variable x, and both are combined with an operation, multiplication. So such type of expressions that involve variables and constants and are combined with the fundamental operations, it is called as algebraic expression. And also note that when such algebraic expressions are equated, that is, we put an equal to sign between them, then this whole thing is called an equation. Let's have some more examples. Suppose I had some money, I gave 16 bucks to one of my friends, and now I have 56 bucks left. Here, the money I had is unknown. And as I gave 16 bucks to one of my friends, that means I need to subtract 16 bucks from my money. So this is the equation and this is expression. Friends, these are some examples of equations and expressions. You all have to match them correctly. In our upcoming sessions, we'll be learning in detail about the algebraic expressions and equations. So that's all for this session. I hope you found it useful. In our next session, we'll learn more on algebra. But if you have any doubts or anything for this session, do let us know in the below comment box. Also, you may like and share the same, as it may help someone.